So up to the point of some of the stuff taken apart on the clausing, right? This is the quill removed. And the key. And this key is broken. Not much. Both ends should look like this. Right there. That little hook on it. 3/16 key. And you can see the wear on the top there where it rides in the quill. On the other side, you can really feel the lip or a little ledge on it. And when you put it in here, you can see how much, oops, drop everything. You can see how much play there is. Let's see here, put it in there. And I don't know if you can see that. It's a lot of play. And that's the rocking motion in the tailstock. So I have some 3/16 key stock here. And there was a little bit of a edge built up along there. So I cleaned that up with a file real quick. And now the key fits in there real nice. Key stock. So, and that's nice and tight. Just almost no play at all, just real nice. So we'll make a new key out of this and see what we can do about making the ends on there so it holds in. This is so it catches in the tailstock and doesn't come out. So we'll see what we can do about that. This is the control panel, and up here in the upper corner you'll see there's a round hole, and it's right there. There was a hole, a small hole there, and I just punched it out to about 2.5 inches. And then I'll swing around the other side of it. Now the wiring's a little bit of a mess still in here. Not sure where I'm going to bring in the, or how I'm going to do the tachometer wire. I'm probably going to come in down here at the bottom. I have a hole in the side, but I think I might put an indicator light on there that to indicate that there's power on the panel. Or I'll punch a hole in the front and put another light in the front. But this is working out extremely well, no problems at all. So here's the fan. Also here's the fan. Here's the fan down here. Now this is a very small fan. This is only about 3 inches. I think it's 3 inches. 3 inches across. And the motor area is huge on this little fan, little muffin fan. And the flow area here is barely wide enough for me to get my little finger through the thickness wise. So it's less than half an inch going through here. And so the screen on the other side didn't need to be very big. There's really not, this fan does not move a lot of air. There's no need to move a lot of air. It's a big box. The VFD also has its own. The VFD also has its own fan. One good thing is that I did mount it against the back of the panel, so that helps as additional heat sink even for it. So there didn't need to be a lot of air movement here. So you'll see the filter arrangement here on the other side.
Well, here's the inlet air filter arrangement. I just drilled out this little drill hole pattern here. I have a piece of Scotch-Brite behind it. Four screws that screwed in, threaded into the panel with a couple little, they have a little, well, just about a little less than a quarter of an inch, but standoff on the screw so it doesn't squish the filter tight, flat, but it's tight. It's tight enough that air's not going to creep around. And just screwed onto the outside here. This works, I've done this on other panels. This actually works really well. The filters on the outside, it's easy to fit, change, and clean. I don't have to open the panel. The having an inlet filter and exhausting air, I like the way that I like that to do that. So this catches the dirt. You're not drawing dirt into the panel, and you're exhausting clean air. It helps keep your panel clean. Instead of drawing in air from the outside and pushing it in, pushing it out the top. I don't like open top panels. Dirt and water or anything could get through there on the top. I don't like having things on the top, but this is near the top.
and it will draw air in across the VFD. So this is the key I need to make for the clausing quill. This end is broken off. It's missing. This is how it was. It was the same on both ends. It kind of is a retaining thing, retainment in the body of the tailstock so it doesn't slip out. So what I've done, what I'm going to do, I was going to use a piece of keystock, but this is a little easier, I think, what I'm going to do. I have a piece of cold rolled quarter inch thick. This is a 3/16 thick. And I've laid it out. I've milled this to length. So it's the length we need. And I'm just going to mill a little small, about 62 thousandths out of the middle here. Then I'll mill it to thickness. And then we'll cut it off. And then I'll mill the back edge of it also. So it's the right height. Quarter inch. Let me just drop everything. So I don't know if you can see the scribe lines, but it's all scribed out, and we'll just take it over to the mill and mill that little section out and go from there. We'll put Tom's sticker up on the board. I think there's a spot right, let's see, right there. I think right, I can get him right there next to Adam. Whoa, that thing just sucked right on there like it's where it's going to go. There we go, Tom. Got quite a few ship. I got a new one up there also, Shark River. That Shark River machine on here now. But my sticker, I still have some room though. Still have room. I still have a lot of room up here. So if you got a sticker you want your on the board, and send me one. I'll put it up. Milling this, we came out Let's see how we came out. 1883. One eight seven five. So we got a little tiny bit of taper. 1876. So we're right there, within a few tenths. Let's see how it fits in here. Okay, right there. It's a little on that end. It's a little tight. The other end where it's 7.5 fits just fine. So I got a tiny bit of taper in the end here. A few tenths. Yep. Where this end is just fine. So this is the end with the notch that needs to really fit. We haven't cut all this off yet. So it's a little just, I mean, if I knocked it in with a hammer, it'd go, of course. But we need a sliding fit. So what I think I'll do is I'm going to take it over. I'm just going to throw in a surface grinder real quick and give this a little buff. I sawed it off, not very straight, but I sawed it off. And drop it in there and take it down to the scribe line. Here we go, the new key. Came out nice, same size, and kind of looks the same. Even I just knocked the corners off with a file, as you can kind of see there. And now we'll see how it fits. See, this is the tapered end. Oh yeah. Just right, just ever so slightly of a rock, but the keyway's also worn a little bit, so, but a tiny bit of movement, but it slides clean. This one, of course, is a huge amount of movement. I mean, it just almost rolls out of there. So we'll finish up putting this back together.
I should show you how this goes together. So this goes, there's a hole, or where the lock goes, there's a, you know, piece removed in there. So that clips over this kind of and sits in here so it doesn't move back and forth. So it's a set distance. So that, there, you heard it. So now that's in there and there's zero movement. I had to file the width of that just a tiny bit so it just fit. So that sits in there and will not move back and forth. And we put a little Weigh lube on the threads here and on the outside of this. This is the quill. We're gonna slip that in there. And just slip it in a few inches and look, basically no movement. That is perfect, and I'll be. There we go. It lubed up. And they're perfect. We're just talking the smallest about amount of movement, which is just right. There we go. That works good. I have a three Morris taper. I have a three Morris taper reamer the viewer had sent in, and I'm probably gonna
when we're a little farther along here, and I'm gonna probably run that reamer in there and just to clean this up a little bit. It's, it has a few rough spots in there, so, and we'll just clean that taper up a little tiny bit. But that, the keyway is if it worked, and that's perfect. You know. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.